Hello there again, minions. It's Wheezy. Today, I'm going to show you the fastest way to unlock the brand new AMP63 automatic pistol sidearm. And surprise, it's not a multiplayer. Let's go do it. Okay, so let's start by looking at the option you are not going to choose, which is using a pistol, eliminate 5 enemies in 20 different completed matches. Again, since this is Cold War, you can't just get 5 kills with a pistol in a multiplayer match and then leave. It won't count towards your overall progress, even though I think the UI will show it, but it won't unlock when you get to the end, which means you have to complete 20 full matches. Getting 5 kills in a match with a pistol, not going to be a big deal, especially in hardcore. But, holy crap, 20 games. That's a couple hours minimum. In zombies, however, the challenge is a bit easier, which is using pistols, get 400 critical kills. And that's a lot more straightforward in a mode where a bunch of zombies run at your face. Now, unlike previous videos where I recommended Outbreak just because it's my preferred zombies method and more fun, that would not be very good for getting precision kills with a pistol because you have to track the zombies down. In the wave-based modes, they all come running to you, and that's a much better way to do it. So that's what I'm going to recommend to you, is to jump into a solo match of D-Machine. Now, the strategy here is going to be very simple. Essentially, we're going to be training zombies and going for critical kills. Now, I am using the Diamati, and I would recommend you do that as well, just because, especially as you get, I don't want to say higher rounds, we're probably only going to go to around 11 in general in this, and I'll explain why. But versus the single fire weapons, I think this is going to give you a little bit more stopping power, a little bit better ability to pop out those critical kills as we go through these modes. So the general strategy I'm going to recommend to you, just as based on how the zombie's health increases, is go through here, focus on training up, getting headshots, and really you don't want to go much past, I wouldn't say round 10 or 11. I think round 11 is when it gives you the option to exfil. So I tried to exfil. I think I played 3 games before I got this finished. And tried to exfil on all of them. The first two I failed. I haven't spent a lot of time in the round-based modes, so I got down to trying to exfil. But I think I got in the first round, the first game I played, I got to round 11. I think I got about 165 kills, critical kills, towards the 400 total. The second game, same thing. I got to round 11 before I tried to exfil. And I think that put me right about almost at 400. Like, I was at like 360 or 370 or something like that. I'll put it up here, obviously. I'm just kind of talking over some of this. And then I'll cut the gameplay in that's relevant as I go. And then when I jumped into the third game, it was, you know, it didn't take me very long at all to finish off the challenge. And then I decided to go ahead and just finish off that game, do some of the, you know, play around in this map since I haven't spent a whole lot of time in it, turn the power on, and then I actually managed to successfully exfil from that one. But in terms of actual gameplay, it took me right at about 45 minutes to completely knock out this challenge versus 20 games of multiplayer, which those are typically at least about, I usually just say 10 minutes is kind of a rule of thumb, but let's say it's 10 minutes times 20, that's 200 minutes, that's, you know, I'm going to round it down, call it 2 hours, 2.5 hours, but it's 2 hours of Cold War multiplayer. And I don't know, maybe that's what you guys are about, in which case, whatever. But in Cold War in general, I'm not having a ton of fun in multiplayer, especially not when I'm forced to use awful weapons, and there are not a lot of great weapons in Cold War multiplayer. So this is what I would recommend to unlock this as quickly as possible. I think if you guys are, you know, better than me, you might be able to knock this out closer to 30 minutes. And matter of fact, if you can do it, if you guys are more familiar with the round and you or with the round-based mode, and you decide to do it in a single game, pack-a-punch the Diamatis and just kind of grind it out that way, I bet you could probably do it even shorter. But for super, super easy, you know, 10 rounds, the zombies aren't hard at all, a little bit of training, you knock it out, exfil or die. Like, you could even just do it until you get mobbed and then just start it again, because you get credit either way. So, yeah, 400 goes pretty fast. Hopefully that's helpful to you guys. I just wanted to share it with you because, again, I got this completionist in me that really wants to unlock everything, even if I'm not going to turn around really and use it in multiplayer. And this also unlocks it for Warzone, and who knows, this may be another, you know, gun that breaks the meta in Warzone. And from what I've seen, this is actually the Akimbo, 63s, AMP63s, are pretty decent for zombies itself, so you might find more of a use for these. I just kind of wanted to unlock them because I like having everything unlocked. And this was the fastest, most painless way to do it. Figured I'd share it with you guys. If it was helpful, go ahead and leave this a like. If you're tired of me telling you the fastest way to unlock things and you just want to grind it like the good Lord Treyarch intended, then you can leave me a dislike. I won't take it too personally. Subscribe for more stuff like this, as well as more random fun. And I will talk to you guys later.